On my way to work, just waiting on the bus, as always. It's Wednesday. I had a little thing about the vlogs last night with regards to the naming convention. I'll be doing the vlogs as in vlog 21, vlog 22, and I'll have it just so it's the vlog number instead. So it doesn't matter when it goes up really, but obviously I'll try and keep to the schedule of Monday to Friday, just so you guys know when it's going up, so you can tune in. It should be there, but it means if someone comes back later on, then it's still in order and makes sense. And the reason why I'm doing it is because yesterday, in yesterday's vlog, you'll see if you go and look at Mondays and Tuesdays vlogs, they've got the same date on them. And what I've been doing before was, if I recorded the vlog, let's say, if I recorded it on a Monday, and then you would see it on Tuesday, I put up the Monday's date. I'm going to streamline this a little bit. It should make a little bit more sense. So you see some changes when it comes to the titles at the start of the videos. I'll just say the vlog number now. Let's see how that goes. Alright people, it's really windy here, so it might be a bit kind of crappy for the sound. Yeah, let us know what games you want us to play next. We've got the Xbox One now in the studio, so I know Gears of War 4 is just about to release. And if there's any other games you want us to play, maybe get a poll or something going. Maybe that can be something for Jiv. We can get a poll going on a regular basis for what games, and then whatever we decide, we can pull in our resources, see who's got what or who's ordering what, to make it a little bit easier to get these games. If we can get it from someone else, then maybe we can order it in or get in touch with the company, try and get a hold of a review copy or something. Coming to work, it's been amazing sunrises, and then going home, it's like, as you can see there, sun's like peering through. It's actually really, really nice. But it only lasts for about an hour when I come into work and I'm sitting on a bus, and then when I go home, by the time I get back to the studio, it's starting to get dark already, so it's a bit frustrating, but missing these beautiful days. Cold, but beautiful. Test. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Are you, using your mic now?
No.
So stream for this evening. If you go and check it out, you should be able to see it on YouTube. In fact, no, I'm not putting this one up on YouTube because it was a bonus stream. This one was, we finished Rayman Legends last week, last Wednesday, so we didn't have a game to play this week, especially with me going away next week to America, so I thought there's no point in starting the game and then taking a week off from it. So instead I came down and I booted up the Xbox One, downloaded Outlast 2 on Xbox One and played the demo. We're probably going to see you guys in the next couple of vlogs, but the next one will be on Saturday for the live stream for Skyward Sword with Connor, and then yeah, I'll be getting prepared for going away. I'm going to put up the first episode of Small Fry Technify on the channel, so you'll be able to see that the weekend. That's the first one, and then the next one is already recorded and edited, ready for the following weekend. So that's the Small Fry Technify beginning. I mentioned yesterday in yesterday's vlog that we were testing the podcast. I got a sample back from Michael today and I listened to it, and he's just put a 10 minute section together, a little bit of tunes in the intro and outro. It's brilliant, really, really happy with it. I think once we get the microphone sorted out from Anton, I don't know if Anton's buying a mic himself, if he's going to get his other one fixed. I'm probably going to buy another one of these Rode mics for the studio, just because they've worked amazingly well when me and Lindsay's been using them. So I'm probably going to get another one for the upcoming streams here in the studio when we're doing the streams with several people. Makes sense to have three people with the mics on instead of two people with a mic and then try to sort out something else. So three people on these mics should work really good, and then I can use that for the podcast as well. So it just makes sense. If we're going to go into the podcast scene, I don't think there's any point in going in there with a substandard podcast that sounds crappy and try to build it up. There's better podcasts out there with better gear. So if we want to compete with them on any level, we need to kind of come up to their game. And I think the content, what we're talking about, is brilliant. It's like, I was listening to it back and I was like, that's great. Minus some tweaks here and there, it was great. It was like something I'd sit and listen to for an hour easily. Like I said, it's designed for you. If you're going to your work, you can just chuck that on in your car or in your headphones or whatever on your phone. You can listen to that podcast in iTunes or SoundCloud and just drive to your work and go to your work. Or when you're coming back from work, you can chuck on. It's designed for those short journeys that you can listen to. So you can put it on any other time, obviously, but it's designed to fit in with that sort of kind of model. So it'll hopefully work really well for you and it'll be good quality as well. All right, guys, working on this vlog that I'm recording right now. I just recorded it a bit on the GH4, which I'm looking at now. And I just recorded it on my Panasonic card, this one here. And I recorded, like, again, a few minutes. I don't know if the card's screwing up. It's now a couple of years old. You can see the little sort of marks on the connectors. Oops, right here. It's hard to see because it's tiny, but I'm going to format the card again and hopefully it's fine. This is a 64 gigabit Read 90 Write 45. It's a pretty good card. It was designed for the Panasonic GH4 for doing 4K recordings. And it's been perfectly flawless, but it's maybe on its last legs. Luckily, I don't save anything on it apart from when I'm filming itself. So it's not that big a deal if it goes. I've got another one that's in the camera just now. This is a Transcend 64 gig one, which cost me like £20 or something. So that's good. That's there anyway. So I've got a backup. And the worst case scenario is I just use that until I buy another one. The Panasonic ones, they're quite expensive because they're actual the brand. I'm just going to get this up just now, get the vlog done, reformat this card, and hopefully that's that card working again. The fact that you can get cards now, you know, there's new cards. I think there was some company, I don't know who it was, had made a card that was 1 terabit for a little SD card, which is crazy. You know, 1 terabit and something like that. That's bigger than my whole hard drive on my Mac. That's crazy. And something that size. But then you start to worry that if you put so much content on that, hundreds of gigs, that little card screws up, then is it really worth it? I think it's only really useful if you're using these cards for something like a camera where you're putting something on and taking it off pretty quickly. So you're not relying on that as your backup medium of storage. So you say, oh, you've got like all my family movies on there and you lose a terabit's worth of memories, you know? So don't ever do that. I wouldn't do that, but I will never put the footage that I film at the time and take it off again almost straight away. And it just goes onto the Mac. I should be backing up the Mac though, because that is the exact same thing. If that ever goes, I'm screwed. So luckily, this is all documented on YouTube. The vlogs are all there on YouTube for posterity. So assuming YouTube doesn't screw up, which I presume they've got backup servers and everything, then we're good. Thanks for joining us again. Leave some comments in the feedback section, leave some feedback in the comment section even. And let us know what you think of the vlogs, what you liked about this vlog, last vlog, and what you're looking forward to. And give us a thumbs up if you're liking the content, if you like the videos, give it a thumbs up like Lindsay's doing. Give us a subscribe as well. Go ahead and hit the subscribe button, that helps us massively. The more people we've got in here checking out the vlogs, the better. Anyway, guys, take care, stay groovy as always, and how's it going, Lindsay? Peace.